So one of the main focus of our research is to control tissue morphogenesis. In particular, we focus on the lung, which provide the body with oxygen and remove carbon dioxide. So our research really looks at how can we develop engineered strategies so that we can control the architectural and the functional aspect of the native human lung. One of the main focus of our research is to control tissue morphogenesis. So the lung accomplishes this through this vast epithelial lining that interfaces directly with inhaled air. So our research developed engineered strategies so that we can recapitulate key architectural and functional aspects of the human lung. By doing so, we would be able to better understand how does the lung function and how the lung is being impacted by inhaled environmental insult or other diseases, and how can we derive and deliver better therapy. Our work will pave the way for regenerative medicine for treating end-stage respiratory diseases. By developing biomimetic conditions for directed lung tissue morphogenesis, we will be able to derive and deliver cells with improved function to expedite tissue repair. So in one of the projects, we're studying the respiratory cilia. So there are tiny hair-like structures cover the entire luminal surface of our respiratory tracts. So they play critical roles in clearing inhaled particles, pathogens, and mucus from the lung. So we engineered a new type of 3D mini lung tissues, we call them organoid, that mimic the respiratory tract and present those beating cilia on its exterior surface. So this revealed a very interesting phenomenon, because this exterior facing cilia power the organoid to spin or move around in 3D and 2D. Now we're leveraging this unique tissue level locomotion to use organoid motility as a readout for cilia function. So while these organoids are great tools to understand lung biology, they remain distant from the real lung tissue due to the lack of control of tissue architecture. Now we're leveraging 3D extrusion printing to provide such guidance. We can generate patient-specific lung cells through stem cell engineering and place them into hydrogel with specific geometric arrangement. Once we place these cells down, they have the inherent ability to self-assemble into viable tissues and form unified lumen at the center. This is a process closely mimicking embryonic lung development. We're now working to see if we can use this technical platform to build branching lung tubules, the very first step towards building a whole lung from scratch. We have also started some new efforts together with my colleagues, Dr. Phil Campbell and Adam Feinberg, to see if we can patent tissues by spatially control the extracellular biomaterials instead of moving the cells around. We're investigating cell-secreted extracellular vesicles as a signaling cue to accomplish this. We have recently published a chemoselective strategy to functionalize common biomaterials to allow precision control of extracellular vesicle delivery. Now we're excited to explore the combination of this technology and 3D bioprinting for patterning complex tissues such as vascularized lung and bone tissues. Some of the main challenges that we encounter as we're pursuing many of the research directions is because many of the project is very multidisciplinary in nature. So in many cases that beyond our expertise inside the lab. But fortunately, you know, we're working at CMU, which has a long-lasting collaborative nature here. So we're constantly working with our colleagues, we combine experts together to make something happen that beyond the capability of one single lab.